ahead of the curve when it comes to organ donation. The number of registered organ donors has increased 13% in 3 years to 2.6 million. That means 63% of Minnesotans are registered donors. And that's way above the national average of 45%. But today, hundreds of health professionals all got together with the hope of moving Minnesota even further up that list. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Tom Durian is here now to tell us how they plan to do it. Tom?
Well, Leah, according to the Minnesota-based organ transplant organization LifeSource, right now more than 3,000 people, I should say, in the upper Midwest are waiting for an organ transplant. Today's message was directed towards nurses and doctors who will encounter potential donor families right on the front lines in hospitals around the metro.
That's the coolest thing about this transplant is I am living a normal, healthy life because of someone else.
25-year-old Mandy Bradley's life changed with one trip to the doctor in 2012. What was originally diagnosed as asthma turned into heart failure, and it became apparent very quickly that only a heart transplant would save her life.
They explained that I would wait in the hospital for 14 days as a status 1A, which is the highest level you can be listed. And after those 14 days, if I did not get a heart, they would send me home. Every time like a nurse or a doctor would come into the room, it's, are they coming in to tell me they found me a heart? It's all you begin to think about. It's that I actually got the heart on the 13th day.
Mandy marks August 17th, 2012 down on her calendar as her heart birthday or second chance at life.
It's definitely a day to celebrate, but at the same time, we have to think about that person did pass away in order for me to live.
And that's what Thursday's Donate Life Symposium was all about. Health professionals heard not only stories of survival, but stories of comfort from donor families.
Because of Stevie's gift, she's no longer in pain.
KSTP meteorologist Ken Barlow shared the story of his brother Steve killed in a car crash in 2010. Steve, or Stevie, as the family liked to call him, was an organ donor.
Not only the recipients get the gift of life, but my brother is alive in 51 other people.
51 other people, and the potential goes beyond that. According to LifeSource, one donor can help the lives of 60 people. These nurses and doctors that were there today will take what they've learned back to the hospitals where they may have to tell a family who is in the middle of the worst moment of their lives just how many people their decision to donate can help. Leah?
Tom, thanks. And according to LifeSource Minnesota, everyone has the potential to be an organ and tissue donor. Most health conditions do not prevent donation, and age is not a factor. You can register online in Minnesota or when you apply for or renew your driver's license. And we've posted a link with more information at KSTP.com.